Ladies and gentlemen, this is Bart Coppens, the Sexy Moth King, and today one of my moths came out. It's a really nice specimen. It's the Ceonothus silk moth, a moth that can be found in the United States among other places. And me being a moth YouTuber, thought this would be the perfect opportunity to tell you something about the biology of this beautiful species. It's really nice with the big gothic colors, can you see that, and white stripe. Really a marvelous insect, very, very beautiful. It's one of my favorites. So let me tell you something about its biology. Wow! Eupacardia caleta, the Ceonothus silk moth, is a marvelous species. They are not that difficult to breed, but they do prefer more dry and warm conditions. This species flies at low elevations in the United States and into the mountains of the United States, Mexico, Honduras and Guatemala at elevations up to 1800 meters and sometimes even higher. This species is found in Texas, Arizona, New Mexico, Guatemala, Honduras and in Central America most of the time. Caterpillars feed on Ceniza or Leucophyllum frutescens, ash tree or Fraxinus, Mexican jumping bean or Sapium biloculare, and Octio or Fucaria splendens. In captivity, they can accept other plants like privet or ligustrum, and even prunus or cherry. They accept many substitutes. In the southeastern mountains of Arizona, there is one brood from July to August. From central Arizona to Mexico, there is one brood from October to January. In South Texas, there are two broods from September, November and March to April. At higher elevations in Mexico, peak flights occur around August and September. They can be found in arid climates. In captivity, hobbyists often raise them because of their stunning size and interesting color patterns. While they're not super difficult, the larvae can be susceptible to diseases in some occasions. So it's recommended to not overcrowd the sensitive caterpillars and give them some respectable space and a clean environment to prevent any sickness. They fly in thorn scrublands, in canyons and valleys, but also sometimes suburbs where a lot of Ceniza hedges are planted in urban environments. Thank you for watching this short and educational video. I hope you enjoyed it regardless. Bye bye.